If you ask him, he said, I will miss the opportunity. He will give you an excuse. He will give you excuses. But most of the Muslim people, Arab, Ajam, East, West, North, South, they are interested to memorize the Quran, to memorize some of it, to memorize most of it. And they are interested, they wish for their children to memorize the Quran. It's essential. We have many real examples in this. To prove that memorizing Quran is not something impossible, it's not something even hard, it's something doable and easy to do. I will start with the story of a very famous Egyptian sheikh, not as a name, but for us as a specialist in this field, we know him very well. May Allah give rest to his soul, Sheikh Rizq Khalil Habba. Sheikh Rizq Khalil Habba, he was a normal person, uneducated. Uneducated means he was able to read and write, but he was not like getting a degree. And before the military coup in 1952, Egypt was in a monarchy system, kingdom. King Farouk, he was born at the time of King Farouk. And at the time, people used to be called as a mandatory service for the military to serve almost 5 years with very low payment. They cannot survive. He was born in north of Egypt. North of Egypt, they have, I will call them farmers, fallahin. They work mainly in the farms. The father needs his family members to help him. They cannot afford to hire some other people. And because of this, many people try to avoid going to, they used to call it jihadiyya at the time. Most of the people wouldn't like to go to the army, and spend 5 years over there.
So he said, "What period is it according to the Christian calendar?"
This in 1930s, 1940s. The military coup took place 1952.
Nasser,
it was not Nasser first, it was Muhammad Najib, but Jamal Abdel Nasser took over. But yes, at the time of Nasser. In the 40s, Sheikh Rizq Habba was was about to be called for the military to serve 5 years. And the way they do it in Egypt, they get the Egyptian to serve in Sudan, because Sudan was part of Egypt at the time, until Uganda was part of Egypt. Egypt was large at the time. And the Sudanese, they bring them to serve in Cairo and Egypt. This is the way they rotate things. Most likely he will be sent to Sudan, spend 5 years over there in a hardship. Then when he went there to the station, they told him the only way to avoid this, you have two ways, either to pay a ransom or to be one of the hafaz of the Quran. They made an exemption for those who are memorizing the Quran because they need them to serve in religious capacities. And the ransom at the time was 20 Egyptian. 20 Egyptian, you could use it at the time to buy maybe 1 acre and a half. 1 acre. It's a big amount at that time. Yani if you know that people, they were working the whole day for each dinar is 100.
Yes.
Then you can imagine how much it is. Fadi told him that he couldn't afford to pay 20 Egyptian pound. And the Egyptian pound at the time was around $6. The value of it equals to $6 at the time. The dollar was 15 of the Egyptian. Now the situation is the opposite. $1 is 15 Egyptian dinar. Then he said he went back and thought about it. He should be called to give himself up to the station in 8 months. This is the time after doing the physical. He said you have 8 months to come. He said at the same night I went to a condolence gathering, and there was a young sheikh who was around 16 years old at the time, came to do the recitation. Around 26 years old to do the recitation, and he said, I remember this verses. He was reciting the last part of Surah Al-Hijr and the beginning of Surah Al-Nahl. And this sheikh was Sheikh Abu Al-Hanin. They were close in the age at the time when the sheikh was reciting, and he said, when I started listening to Sheikh Abu Al-Hanin, I feel that this Quran is revealed to me. At the moment, I said, I didn't feel anyone else, but the sheikh is reciting, even I didn't focus on him, but I felt that the Jibreel bringing the Quran to me fresh, like it's an outreach to him. And he said, right away, I left, and I went to one of the sheikhs, the Muhafiz, teacher of the Quran, and I told him, I said, this is the situation. Today, I got a message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that I was listening to Sheikh Abu Al-Hanin Shaisha, and I did not feel anyone around me, and I felt that the Quran is coming from the heavens to my heart. And he told him about the deadline. The Sheikh told him, no, you cannot do it. You are working as a farmer, and you expect yourself to memorize the Quran in 8 months. Not only this, you go and do a test. You will not go to the army and tell them, okay, I'm memorizing Quran, please release me. No, they have a Lajna, a committee to test people. And this is not like my Lajna, my committee. Here is big difference. Yani, many people, they will not pass this exam. I went through this. I know how they do the testing. But he said, to make long story short, and he said, I went there, and by the last day of the 8 months, I was able to complete memorizing the entire Quran. I was ready to. And he said, he went there, and he was not only able to answer the questions, he was a challenge to the committee. To the extent that this student, they started asking him questions for things they were mentioned just once in the Quran. They are not repeated, just once. For example, إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَزِيزًا حَكِيمًا. They will not tell him the beginning of the verse. They will not tell him the entire verse. Just, إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَزِيزًا حَكِيمًا. Go on. You have to be, when he was able also to answer these questions, try to mix up things for him. He said, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ, in a surah, doesn't have يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ at all. Because Ya Ayyuhan Nas mainly comes in Mecca. But they bring Ya Ayyuhan Nas in Surah in Medina. In Medina, they say Ya Ayyuhan Ladina Amanu. Not everyone, Ya Ayyuhan Amanu specific. So they start mixing up this kind of things. And he was able that they gave him excellent, and he was relieved from this service. memorizing this, he was around 20 years old. I brought this to start with, before I go through the tips, a few tips, how can you memorize it? It's the easy way to memorize the Quran. Just to say one question, I am kind of old. It's too late for me to pick up. I tried many times, but you know, I have many things in my mind. The family, the committee, the service, the board, the business. Now, this is a proof that the age is not an obstacle. I was leading prayer in Ramadan in one of the years in Egypt. I was leading in Masjid Istiqama. It's one of the big mosques in Al-Jiza, in Midan Square, for 5 years, in Ramadan. And we do the first round, which is Salatul Al-Qiyam, after Isha. Then everyone goes home. Around 2 a.m., we wake up everyone in the masjid, and they do another round for 3 hours. Sometimes we stop at 1 for 4 hours. We do this from the night of 21st to the night of 27th. You need to finish the Quran, to do another khatm of the Quran in 7 nights. This means if you divide 30 by 7, it will give you around 4.5, around this. To do 4.5 juz, which is by itself close to 90 pages, you have to read with high speed. Faster than what I do in Ramadan here, way faster than this. And if you are doing this, first you have to be very focused, not to make any mistakes, because there is no chance to make mistakes in this. But not only this, the one who is following up behind you also, he should be very, very sharp. I didn't expect anyone, even when if I made a mistake, I forgot something, I didn't expect anyone to correct me, because it was not easy for those who are holding the Mus'haf to follow. What about those who are memorizing? In around Surah Al-A'raf, I kept this tradition, doing this for like 2 nights, and the 3rd night, I made a mistake. And I had someone correcting me, and correcting me in a perfect way. Not like when here, when people there, when you make a mistake, everyone would, alhamdulillah, the Imam made a mistake. Everyone would like to get a chance to. He made it in a perfect way, the way that you will catch up and you will continue. This is an art by itself. This is the 3rd night. In the 4th night, when we started, usually we don't make mistakes in the long surahs. Like, we don't make mistakes in Baqarah. But when we start, you making the medium surahs, and sometimes short surahs, you make mistakes. In the 3rd night, I made 2 mistakes in the 4th night. And also, I heard the same sound. I didn't ask for the first time, the second time. And also, he corrected me in very smart way. Then after I finished the prayer, I asked one of the people who were behind me in the first time, I said, who's this person who's correcting me? They said, you don't know him? He said, no, I was facing the Qibla. I'm not the prophet, I don't see with my back. They said, no, this is a judge, such and such. First, judge, no, he's not a sheikh. I have 5-6 people, shuyukh, memorizing the Quran behind me. So he's not one of the shuyukh that they are praying with me. But they said, no, he's a judge. Then I said to the guy, I said, please, after Fajr, can you introduce him to me? He came, a nice guy, around. I asked him, how old are you? The first question. How old are you? Before I asked him, where do you judge and stuff, he said, I'm 57. 57. I told him, oh, it's what do you do for a living? He said, I am a judge in Jiza Court. up with me. I was reciting very fast and you were correcting me just with one word. It looks like this, I'm telling him, it looks like you are memorizing the Quran when you were 6 years old, 7 years old. He said, no, I just memorized the Quran 3 years ago. 3 years ago? No, I told, no, this is a story. This is the story that I would like to hear. 3 years ago, when you were 54, 55, this can't be, and even if you did it, no way for you to follow up with me like this. I'm memorizing from a young age, and I know how hard you go with the memorization as you go in your age. Tell me your story. Fahi said, before I was like a regular person, judge busy with law and studying and stuff and teaching sometimes in the university and dealing with the cases. He said, the Department of Justice in Arabic Peninsula, they sent for the Department of Justice in Egypt to send some judges to help them to legalize the Islamic law. Because it was left for the shuyukh. Sheikh Kamil said, oh, give him 10 lashes. The other one said, give him 20 lashes. But there was no protocol. But he said, we need people just to make thick for the lawyers to dispute the cases. They need to know the articles, Article 1, Article 2, articles. But he called many of the Egyptian judges, because we are very advanced in this. In the Middle East, we are the first, because we started making this in 1860s, at the time of Khidr Ismail. Even before the Ottoman, when they made Majalat al-Ahkam al-Adliya at the Sultan Abdulaziz side. So we are very advanced in this, very very well found, very, very well established. But he called them, and they were residing in Jeddah, 50 minutes from Kaaba. He said, we were working only 2 days. 2 days, just to talk. The other 5 days, I take my car and go every day from the morning until the evening in Al-Haram in Mecca, the Holy House. Over there, he committed himself to an Egyptian sheikh, and he said, I would like to memorize the Quran. I have time. Why I don't try it? And the Egyptian sheikh helped him, and he said, in 3 years, I memorized the Quran. I did. For the entire period that I spent over there, I memorized the Quran, and I had the chance to read, when I finished memorizing, to read it like more than 50 times from the memory. And he said, since this time, I committed myself to make khatm by with myself every week. The point that I'm trying to raise, this person is not a single case. I know many people. I told you about Sheikh Rizq Habba, that he was a challenge to finish, and he did it for a purpose of dunya, not to serve in the army. And he did it. And later on, he became Sheikh al Qurra in Egypt, the head of all of Sheikh in Egypt. Led him to another stage. Even he didn't think about it. What he thought about, not to serve in the army, but he ended up being a head Shaykh al-Maqariq fi Masr. And also this judge, he was sent to another mission, but he decided to do it, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him. And this, the real interpretation of the verse, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِنْ مُدَّكْرِ. We have made the Qur'an easy to be recited, to be understood, to be memorized. The dhikr, because dhikr is all of them, all of these meanings. Then who is willing to do it? فَهَلْ مِنْ مُدَّكَرْ. Who is willing to do that? If you did decide to do it and you did it in the right way, I guarantee for you 100%, even if you are 80 years old, you will do it. 80 years old, because the Quran didn't make it conditional. It said, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ, for the children, for the young ages. No. It's for everyone. And also the proof of it, the time of the Sahaba, There is many Sahaba learned the Quran when they were 60 years old. يعني سهاء حكيم ابن حزام, he accepted Islam when he was 60 years old. And he lived in Jahiliyyah 60 years and he lived in Islam 60 years. 60 years there and he died when 120. Hassan ibn Thabit also accepted Islam when he was 60 years old. He was an old man. There is many, many of the companions memorized the Quran when they were in old ages. Did not prevent them. The age does not prevent anyone from memorizing. I will give you a few tips from my own experience to make it easy for you. But first of all, we should not bring up issue the age that much. The age can help, but does not prevent. The age help can help, but does not prevent. We should not use it as an excuse. The first step, commit yourself to a sheikh. Commit yourself to a source to help you memorizing. People think that holding the Quran by themselves, why do I need a sheikh? You don't need a sheikh only just to make your recitation perfect, but it's a commitment. It's a commitment. يعني, when I was memorizing myself and I was going with my bike back and forth to the school, in some days I was not willing to memorize. But when I pass by the house of the sheikh, I feel bad. And I stop whenever I get, it wasn't my way. But when even because of the commitment, not to mention that if I was, I had to go one day and they didn't, Sheikh sees me, where are you? Why didn't you come? The commitment itself is not only just he was teaching me the proper pronunciation of the, no, it's a commitment, create a commitment. And it's not easy to go away with this commitment. It's not easy to get rid of it when you commit yourself to a sheikh. But it's very easy to get rid of any other commitments. Say, many people, they say, inshallah, every day I will recite one page. Not memorize, I will recite one page. You do it the first day, second day. Huh? And how many people left the group assembly?
I have 85 of that.
Then even reciting, you see some people is scared, what's the big deal? And you skip one day, you skip the second day, you skip the third day, forget about it. But with the sheikh, no, when you see, we are created in this way. We feel shyness from each other, but we don't feel shy from ourselves. For the sheikh, it's very important also because regardless of how good you are in Arabic, Quranic accent is different. I was reading better than most of my teachers who are not memorizing the Quran. And they were professors in Arabic grammar. Professors in Arabic grammar. But this has nothing to do. Yes, he can make analysis. He'll tell you, oh, this is subject, this is object, this is adverb, this is this and this. Will give you, oh, this is a vowel O, this is vowel E, this. He will tell you this. Make analysis. But when you ask him to read, he makes mistakes because he didn't learn the Quranic accent. Quranic accents beyond the Arabic language. And this is why you see Indonesian reading Quran fluently and some Arab people struggling. If it's all about Arabic, it shouldn't be this way. People from Pakistan or Hind or Turkey, they are really the best reciters. I listen to Turkish. I'm sure that you visited Turkey and listen to the. I didn't see a single imam leading prayer in Turkey with not amazing voice, not amazing recitation. I don't know what they do over there. I heard many imams in Egypt, you cannot listen to them. it's not about the Arabic language. This is a Quranic accent. Yani something, it's only in Quran. Regardless, it's beyond the ethnicity. This one, you will get it from Sheikh. You will not get it from me. I got it from my Sheikh, and my Sheikh got it from his Sheikh, and you go with the chain until you reach the Prophet, peace be upon him. This is the way it is. Any other way, you could make a mistake. Number two, choosing the right time. Yani, I am amazed when I see, many people drive a lot. But when you are driving 93 going to Boston, which is a test by itself, a trial. For people, they holding the Quran and try to memorize. Memorize, and you have 1 million car in right side, 1 million car in the left side, and people going back and forth, and a lot of disturbance. You have to know that you are not. We as people, they have a vision, they can see. We use two things to memorize: copying the image and inculcating things, memorizing things, saving things in our memory. But when we save things in our memory as a seeing people, we memorize it with the image. For example, when I say iPhone, you don't remember just I and P H O N E. No, all you bring the image. Right away, your mind will bring the image. When you say Alif Lam Mim, same thing. Right away, you bring the image. For if you have a pure image being saved, your memorization will be good. But if you have a confused image, oh, you have Alif Lam Mim with Akira, C, X, what's the Akira? X?
What's Mustafian?
The SUV, what's CX? Well, Ali?
RX.
RX, yeah?
MDX.
You have one here mixed with this, one mixed with the Toyota Camry, one mixed. It's all with Alif Lam Mim. You know that. I can tell you right now which place I was in when I was memorizing surahs. Yani, when you tell me surah such and such, I will tell you where I was. Which was saved also with the same, with this. Choosing the right time, it's very important. Kids jumping right and left around you. Jumping right and left. This is not a good time for memorization. And in Jum'ah, while everyone is sitting here and reading, and this is not a good, because you will get one word here, one word there. Trying to memorize after work when you are exhausted completely and tired, and coming back with less energy, and you hold the mushaf. This is not a good time. This is not a good potential. The best time, when you woke up early in the morning. If you woke up at the evening after having enough sleep for Fajr, this is a good time. When you are energetic, you have energy, and when you are free from the attractions, this is the best time to memorize. You don't need, you say, you are asking for hard, there is attraction. No, you don't need to spend much time. If you did 10 minutes in this state, in one of these states, better than 1 hour in the state of attractions, in the state of deviations around you. Better than 1 hour. And try it yourself. Try to memorize just 10 minutes early in the morning. But don't do it when you are hungry. Just 10 minutes. And compare it with 1 hour after coming from work, when you come back from work. You will see that 10 minutes, way much better than the. And second, third, choosing the right place. Right place, try to avoid
any area of attraction. And some people, they go to parks. Park is a good place, right? But it's a good place to relax, not to memorize. When you see people going and someone jogging and women doing misharifi, men doing that. And no, there is many attractions around you taking your eyes away. But try to choose the right place. One of the right places, you can build a strong relation with. You can link the memorization with the place. For example, you have a section in your home, and always I say this, when we buy our house, try to have a small area for religious service. Make your own mosque over there. Don't substitute the masjid, but make your own mosque for dhikr. And over there you can put a prayer rug in a section that يعني, should be known for everyone. This is, we call it, in our tradition, khulwa. Khulwa means a private place for your religious service. When you go there, even if you don't have energy to memorize, when you sit there, you will memorize. When you get used to this. Choosing the right place try to avoid memorizing while you are riding the train. Going back from here, from Quincy Station to Boston and holding the Mus'haf. I used to see this in the subway in Egypt. Subway in Egypt, there is a big difference between, I didn't try this one, I don't know how busy it is, but subway in Egypt, it's a fight. Just you get people and keep squeezing to the extent you say, there is no more room to squeeze, and all of a sudden you get double this number and you squeeze also. I saw this in Bangladesh. Who's from Bangladesh? Huh? I saw amazing transportation, the buses over there, but it's amazing buses. And the bus fit, for example, 60, 70 people, 600. Everywhere.
Next time we should try Pakistan.
Wallahi, I've been told this. The good thing that they decorate the bus from outside. Okay, a lot of flower stuff.
but you
see it only from outside, huh?
Pakistan has no modern buses and everything.
Oh, do you have 600 also?
Yeah. No.
Yeah?
Also trains, you know.
But don't tell me that they are memorizing in this environment. Yani someone, I saw this in subway, I was many people with young fellows and middle-aged fellows, they are yani good, they have good intention, but yeah, please, my brother, please, this is not the... I was riding a train from Cairo. Please tell me when I stop. This is a story time. I was riding the train from Cairo to my hometown in South Egypt. Say 5-6 hours train. But I was lucky, طبعاً, alhamdulillah, as a religious, I used to get many benefits. I was using a business class. Business class, and I took train at night to sleep. 6 hours, it's boring, and we had no iPhone at the time, no iPad, no tablet. I choose train 12 a.m. Just 30 minutes when we يعني, got in a situation that we started having heavy head. Someone in the middle of the car started reciting with loud sound. I had an old man. I don't know if you saw Egyptian, South Egyptian style of clothes. I wish that I got one here to give the Jum'ah, to wear it in the Jum'ah. It's a special one, but you can see it in Egyptian movie, but go like South Egyptian stuff. When you see someone like this, yeah, he could be Mukhtar of the area, it could be Al-Umda, the mayor of the area, it could be someone with nice clothes, but you don't expect that he will be religious, because the religious, we wear different clothes. You see it in the one I wear in Naeem. The guy woke up and very upset from the other one with big beard. And he said, guy. I thought that he's referring, that he's making noise at night, and this is not the place to memorize Quran. He keep repeating the verses. Looks like he was memorizing. If I said the most amazing thing that he is half of his recitation is wrong. I realized this myself, because I'm hafiz. I realized, I didn't think that he was, as I said, look at him, half of his recitation is wrong. But I got the carrier, I told him, please give us mercy. Yani, I can listen to you, I can help you, but give us some mercy because you are killing me and the guy next to me by making this major mistakes. But this also is not the proper place to memorize. You should not be distracting the others. Number four, when you memorize, try to use one copy of the Quran. And now it became very common to use the Medina Muslim. And even the other publications are imitating the Medina Mus'haf. Syria, Egypt now change. But before, at my time, يعني, you were lucky if you got a copy of the Mus'haf. And we used to get it from different publishers. Sometimes they make 16 lines, sometimes they make 15 lines, sometimes they make 14 lines in each page, and based on this, the verses are, myself, I did this mistake, and this why now I have problem. I cannot read from the Mus'haf anymore. Yani in Ramadan, when, before Maghrib, when I said with myself, if I got the Quran, the Medina Mus'haf, I started reading, I get confused, and I use only my memory. I rely only on my memory. Just I said before, Maghrib and recite the Juz with my memory, but using the Quran is very challenging for me. It's very challenging for me to read from the book. But now you see this problem with مثلا, for most of the Arab people, they are using the Medina copy now, which is good. Just stick to one copy. But it's more confusing for the end Pakistani brothers. They can, when they come to the masjid, they see Medina copy. When they go back home, they have this red one with yellow pages, and it's mainly the writing of Eastern style. If you decided to use the Indo-Pakistani one, stick to it, because whatever you see there, it will be printed, covered in your memory. If you keep moving, you will get your lines confused. You'll get your line confused and you will not be able to recognize. Now, if you tell me, if you ask me for my print, the one that I use, where is وَقَالَ نِسْوَةٌ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ, I will tell you where exactly. Oh, this came in the middle of the page, مصحف المعلم. But now, if you ask me, where is it in this Medina مصحف, I don't know. Yes. I don't know it because I did not use this one. When you make a mistake, this will help you. It will help you to correct your recitation. I will tell you this story also, since this is the night of the stories. When I was in college, in the first year, I made good credibility about how strong I am in my memorization. To the extent, any Quran competition nationwide, from Alexandria to Aswan, from north to south, I beat everyone. I took the first position. By second year, I got very strong ego. To the extent that those who are testing me, they were afraid. Yani when they mentioned name Khalid Nasr, by default, you will take the first position. There was a competition in the club, the faculty club. 50 Egyptian engineers. For someone like me with this level, it's not much. I was doing things for 1,500, all the Umrah. But I was too greedy at the time, in second year. I said, why should I leave? I will go and get the 50. So I told my colleagues in the door, just I have short trip, I will go and collect 50 Egyptians and come back. This is as a result of the ego that those who are testing you are afraid. If I went there, the organizer, who was one of my teachers in the college, introduced me to the one who's doing the test, and he scared him. He told him, this is our genius one in the college. And he kept telling him, he was memorizing the Quran with the, at the time I had the seven recitations. And the seven recitations, and give him. And I sit down with him, but I realized something strange. He's bringing a copy of the Mus'haf I didn't see before. Something like this, like Cyclopedia. I didn't see a copy of the Mus'haf, looks like a handwriting. Big, I didn't see it before. And when he opens, like one third of it for me, like the entire Quran in my copy. He told me the first question, say such and such. I got a block in my mind completely. And I started reciting. I did not make any mistake. I recited for like 6-7 lines. But myself, I didn't know where I'm reciting, completely black. And for his copy, this was not what it came to be. This verse, the beginning of the verse came twice in the Quran. And he was bringing the first one, and I was reciting in the second one. He was looking at Surah Al-A'raf, and I was reciting in Surah Al-Ra'd. I was doing good, but I didn't realize. When he looked at the Mus'haf, I was not hafiz. He said, no, this is wrong. I told him, do you think that I made up all of these 10-6 lines? I did not make it. It's supposed to be in the Quran. Check your copy. I looked at the copy. He said, what kind of Quran you are having? I tried to figure it out myself. I said, where is he from the Quran? But one third for him is not, still you cannot tell where is he in this verse. He failed me in the first one. The second one, he gave me a question, I couldn't say a word. Taban, he became merciful. He said, oh, this is Antar ibn Shaddad that you are scaring me with. This is your genius one. He couldn't. Not to embarrass me more, he said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَيْبِ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ وَأَجْرٌ كَبِيرٌ. You know it, huh? What is it in the Quran? إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَيْبِ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ وَأَجْرٌ كَبِيرٌ. Surah Tabarak, right? Surah Al-Mulk. Most of the people memorizing. I told him, is this Quran? I didn't know it. I didn't know anything. I got completely blind. This was a lesson for me. Also, knowing the Mus'haf, 5 more minutes, inshallah. Some people, when they memorize the Quran, they focus, they would like to be Sheikh Abdul Basit. From the day one, they would like to be, No, this is not the time when you're memorizing, forget about Abdul Basit for a while. Later on, when you finish, try to be Abdul Basit, try to be Mustafa Ismail, try to be any other qari. But not from the day one. Because when you keep yourself busy with the donations, you will be confused with the recitation. But the best way is keep one tune and go with it. Keep one tune and go with it. Donations will not go away later on. When you memorize surah perfect, just go and do donations. But while you are memorizing, don't try to focus on the donations. See people, I saw it when I was teaching Quran, people try. Say, not now, please, not now. The Sheikh would like to do like you when you do the, or they ask me, I would like to do Nahawand, I would like to do Ras, I would like to sub. Not now, forget about these donations now. Just focus and choose one tone and keep doing it. And later on when you memorize, when you finish memorization, you can start changing this donation because you will be confused. And if you don't have a perfect memorization, the donations will take you away. They will take part of your attention from the memorization and you will lose the focus. Very important thing when you memorize Quran, which is number 6 or 7 or whatever, people memorize single verses. This is very dangerous. It's not good. You have to deal with the Quran like one sentence. If I don't stop when you are memorizing, there First, those who are using Mus'haf al-Madina, when you do single verses, at the end, every page end with the end of the verse. We call it fasila. They don't continue. يعني they made the writing, the way they wrote the Quran in this Mus'haf, that the end of the page is the end of the verse. You can test it yourself. They don't have connected verses. Part of it in the first page, part of it in the second page. They don't have it. And because of this, when you memorize single verses at the end of the page, it's very hard for you to recall what is the beginning of the next page. But if they are connected, you are going, you are streaming. But the best way to memorize, deal with the Quran like one verse. Don't stop when you are memorizing. This will help you in another thing, to know the vowels. يعني الرحمن, what is the vowel of الرحمن? Noon, رحمن. If you kept saying الرحمن and you don't know the Arabic grammar, you might be الرحمن, الرحمن. But you say الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان, and you'd like to stop, say علمه البيان. But when you would like to say الشمس والقمر بحسبان, go back and say علمه البيان الشمس والقمر, شمس والقمر بحسن, علمه البيان الشمس والقمر بحسن, بان والنجم والشجر يسجدان, والسماء رفعها وضع الميزان, ألا تطغوا في الميزان, وأقيموا الوزن بالقسط ولا تخسروا الميزان. And when you keep doing this, you will know all of the vowels. We had a substitute in my time because we were writing with the vowels. You have to write the page 10 times. 15 times, 20 times, for we know the vowels, we covered all of the vowels. But now when you memorize just by stop, when you are asked to continue, you will not be able to figure out about the vowels. For just when you memorize, just the state of memorization, keep streaming and don't stop. When you need to take your breath, stop and go back and continue and so on and so forth. And in this case, you will not forget and you will not need, oh, this is the end of the page, this is the beginning of the other page. The last one, قَلِيلٌ دَائِمْ خَيْرٌ مِّن كَثِيرٍ مُنْقَطَعٍ. قَلِيلٌ دَائِمْ خَيْرٌ مِّن كَثِيرٍ مُنْقَطَعٍ. Less you do in the regular basis, little you do in the regular basis, way much better than much you do, but you don't continue. خير الحديث is خير الأعمال أدومها وإن قل. The best amongst your deeds, the one you do it in the regular basis, even if it's little. People did it, so I would like to do قيام, do two rak'ahat and go sleep. It's better than when you do it every night, it's better than doing 30 rak'ahat or 100 rak'ahat in one night. Because you will not be able to do 100 rak'at every night. For here, if you are able to memorize 10 verses every day, do it 5. And if you are able to memorize 5, do it 2. But when you do 2, second day do 2. It will be easy for you. Always I say this, when I was in the college, we were in the dorm, my college, طبعاً, were memorizing, we were shuyukh. You are dealing with shuyukh right and left. Even the females, they were shuyukh also. But in the dorm, we had people from medical school, from business school, from law school, from what others in the university, in the dorm, many other agriculture school, many other schools. And they were trying to memorize. They get fascinated by listening to Khalid Nasr or Sheikh Mukhtar or the other reciters. They keep asking, we would like to say, commit yourself with me from now. I'm in the first year of the dorm. By just doing 2 ayat every day, when I graduate, when you graduate, you'll be memorizing Quran. Just do it this way. Not many of them listen. But if they listen, 2 verses every day in the in the entire season, from September to June, imagine how much you will memorize. When we did memorization for the Qira'at, we had to memorize a poem. The poem, it's 1,000 173 lines. 1173 أبياتها 1000 تزيد ثلاثة مع 170 دورا وكمال يبقى كام؟ 1173. It was hard. يعني when you read it, when you read it, يعني it means it's not Arabic. مالك يوم مالك نظل الروا السلطة مع سلطة زين خلف الغلا كيف وقع. No one will understand even this is a genius stuff. But what we did, just we go around the pillar, one of the pillars of the masjid, we make tawaf. The whole day, just one line. The whole day, just one line. But over the time, in 3 years, you will memorize it, right? You keep making tawaf. And 1 hour you memorize, even if it's hard, the second day you do the first one with the second one, the third one with the fourth one with this, and you keep going. But we were energetic and we were focused on this. So imagine now just 2 verses, 1 verse every day. 1 verse, what does it take from you? It will not take that much, but after 1 year you will be memorizing more than Surah Al-Baqarah. Close to Al-Baqarah and Ali Imran. Can you imagine? It's easy and doable. And later on, when you do this for 1 year, the second year, I guarantee for you will be able to do 5 verses. Because memorization will help to do more memorization. This is just a few tips. I wish that will help you if you have intention. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give all of us success to memorize the Quran and at least to memorize some. It's barakah. It's barakah. And always I say, when we have a hafiz within the house, it's a barakah for the entire house. When we have a hafiz in the community, it's a blessing for everyone. Even if you are not in direct contact with this person, but it's a blessing. A hafiz is a great thing. And this is not from me. This is ثم أورثنا الكتاب الذين اصطفينا من عبيد. They are chosen. الله يصطفي من الملائكة رسلا ومن الناس. From angels, Jibreel, from the human prophets and Qurra and ulama. For they are chosen people. Chosen people are barakah for and blessings for everyone. Say that and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of our sins, accept all of our good deeds, and barakah for another woman, and ask Allah for the women of 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 the women. More than one, inshallah, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless them, protect them from the hellfire, and secure their place in the paradise, and compensate them by His own generous way, and give success and tawfiq for their family members, inshallah.